We had a pleasure to meet Ian Burbidge from RSA Lab today. And the mission of RSA is to tackle social, societal problems through research, innovations, and other kind of actions, right? So Ian, could you open more what you're actually doing in practice? Mm-hmm.
So I'm part of the RSA Lab, and what we're trying to do is to gain a deeper understanding of how change happens, how we can tackle some of those real challenges that we face as society, and developing out some tools and techniques and approaches that enable us to do that. And part of our mission is to then share that with the wider world so that we have a global community of change makers, people who are trying to create impact in their work, whether that's in their lives, their communities, in their organisations. And so we try and get these ideas up and out in whatever way that we can. So it's things like running sessions like we've just done here with you guys, which is great. It's through public events, through animations on our website you can find. And we have, now we've got 30,000 RSA Fellows all across the globe, including Finland. So hey, that's pretty cool. Yeah.
So 30,000, you said. Okay. So you're organizing some sort of events for them. What kind of other content you're offering to these fellows?
So what we try and do is, so if I just briefly explain the structure of the RSA, we have what I would describe as a traditional think tank, but with a purpose. So we have a team of researchers who go deep on core issues, whether it's the future of work, whether it's artificial intelligence and ethics, whether it's health and the role of social movements, or inclusive growth. There's all sorts of current challenges that we're looking at. And what we try and do is understand those challenges quite deeply, but then turn those insights into materials that people can use. And, you know, it's not enough anymore just to publish a report to try and influence policymakers. We want to get content out for people in a format and in a way that they can use. So that could be things like, a slide deck with some learning materials that would enable people to run a workshop in their community about how you might understand a problem or what inclusive growth might look like in a particular city. Or it could be that we have speakers come along and share their insights and ideas from their research. We mobilise the fellowship themselves to share their understanding of an issue or a challenge. Mm-hmm. We have fellow-led networks on creativity in public services, on health and social care, on education and innovation, on all sorts of topics in a sort of a self-organising way. And whilst there is a UK focus, there's still a global element to that. So we have people who are interested in education across the world. Mm-hmm. We have people who are interested in very local challenges, whether it's in New Zealand or America or Wales or whichever country it might be. We're increasingly talking about basic income as an alternative to some of the conditional welfare systems that exist. And clearly the Finnish trials in Canada, in Africa, in a number of countries, there are issues and potential ways we might address those issues that are global by nature. And what we try and do is find ways of surfacing the learning. And I think often we're kind of agnostic about what the solution might look like, but we are keen that we encourage people to play around with potential solutions and learn what works along the way.
Yeah, so thinking more systemically. And you're working with wide range of societal issues, and you mentioned these tools you're creating. So are they available for everyone to use, like on your websites or so? Or?
Yeah, so we're working towards that. At the moment, we're still operating in beta, for want of a better phrase. And so sessions like today were about testing our thinking and our insights. But we've got a program of work over the next 12 months to build that into a playbook or a series of methods that people can download and use for themselves. So that's like the coordinated piece around our model of change, which is, you know, this idea that we need to think systemically but act entrepreneurially. So that's supported with these materials and insights and methods and what have you. But individual projects have their own presence on our website and have their own materials that people can download. And sometimes that's a report, sometimes it's a slide deck, sometimes it's a video you can watch. So there's different means of engaging with our work. But I would just say watch this space, because we really want to get this stuff out, this content out, because it's, you know, it's no use trapped in our heads.
Yeah, that's true. And I think our audience can be interested in this fellow community. So is it possible to join it somehow, or do you need to be a part, like take part of some program or event, or how does it work?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, anybody can become a fellow of the RSA. We're an a broad church, for want of a better phrase, and all we look for is people that share the mission, which is around social change. People that are trying to tackle some of these entrenched challenges that we all face, that play out differently in different communities or in different countries. But there's so much rich learning and insight to be shared that we encourage anybody that's interested in that to get involved. And you can do that through our website. That's relatively easy, just to sign up and join up. It would be kind of cool to have a real spike of applications from Finland and have a growing community over there. And then we'll come out and do some cool work with you guys. That would be good.
That sounds great. Thank you so much, Ian.
It's a pleasure.